Myself, Bhagyasri Hire. I am in the project group of Suyog Bagul, Yogeshwari Helaskar and Pranali Narvade. We are doing our final year BTech project, Completion of Instrumentation Engineering, which is named as Material Sorting Machine. As now I am going to demonstrate you view of our project model. In this final year project, we are going to make a material sorting machine. As we know that the material sorting is an important aspect in any industry. Most of the time color based material sorting is preferred in many industries. Our system will have a mechanism to detect color and according to that, sorted items can be obtained. The system uses Arduino connected to a controller circuit. The controller circuit consists of a color sensor attached to it. Detects color of a material in front of it. A motor is used to put that material in front of color sensor. When color is detected, a signal is sent to the sorting machine, which uses another motor to position the sorting tube towards the respective section. A feeder is then used to push those materials towards the tube so that they get sorted and next place material is pulled by the feeder. So as to keep track of the number of material being sorted in each section. Introduction to color-based material sorting. Color-based object sorting is having wide uses in material sorting, fruit sorting, candy and chocolate sorting industry. This system puts forward a mechanism to detect color and sort items through image processing. Once identify a mechanism, it is used to sort the particular material into particular bins basket. We demonstrate the mechanism using a color sensor with electronic circuit along with sorting machine uses bins. Using a color sensor with electronic circuit along with sorting machine uses bin, the system uses Arduino connected to a controller circuit to achieve this task. The controller circuit consists of a TCS3200 color sensor attached to it that detects color of the small object in front of it. A motor is used to feed an object to the TCS3200 color sensor chamber. As soon as the color is detected, a signal is sent to the sensor. Sorted mechanism which uses a motor to position the sorting tube towards respective section. A feeder is then used to push the object towards the tube so that it gets sorted and next object is pulled in by the feeder. Thank you.
Hello everyone, this is Yogeshwari. We have made our project model in group of four and our project title is Material Sorting Machine. Actually, the actual model is not with me. This is at Bhagyashree's place and due to this pandemic, I am unable to get it. So, I just demonstrate the working and mechanism of our project model. Our project model is all about color sorting based and here we have used Arduino Uno ATmega 3280 as a microcontroller and this one is the color sensor TCS3200 and these two are servo motors of SG19S respectively. And now I am going to explain some features and specifications of the components which are used. So this first one is the color sensor. This is the TCS3200 color sensor. As we can see, this is the programmable color light to frequency converter and it can detect a wide variety of color and this module has this four white LEDs. And this module is designed in such a way that these white LEDs will light the object and reflections from that object to the sensor. So it can detect the various colors of object and use output in terms of square wave and its frequency frequency is directly proportional to the light sensitivity and it operates voltage with
is in the range, this range is lies between in between 2.7 volt to 5.5 volt. So we can see its voltage pin is connected to the 5 volts of Arduino Uno respectively. So the sensor allows selectable frequency scaling, and its output frequency changes with the light intensity of the color. The next components are two DC servo motors which are used here. These two DC motors plays a very important role in the sorting mechanism. So it gives rotation of 180 degree to 360 degree. This first motor, which is placed at upper side and which is used for placing the object in front of the sensor, and after that these bottom servo motors placing the object in the respective bins through these feeders, and these baskets are used for the collection of the materials respectively. Now I am going to show you the code of our project. So this is the code of our project. Now I am going to run this program. So firstly we will compile it. And it's done. After that we will upload the code. And the code is uploading. And it's done now. Now if we run the serial monitor here, then we will start getting some values, and these values depends on the selected frequency scaling, as we have used RGB model here. So it will show its output in the form of red, green and blue color, and these three different values are different due to the different sensitivity of each photodiode type. Now let us see how these values react when we will put different color in front of the sensor. So if we put the red color in front of the sensor, then color sensor TCS3200 sends the color of that object. And on serial monitor here initial values will drop down, you can see, and different values are coming now. Now you can see the graph also on serial plotter. So for that here we have to open serial plotter. So here graph is showing characteristics of color of RGB which is varying continuously. We have used color sensor TCS3200 and two DC servo motor and Arduino. So according to that, the nature of the graph is variable according to the color and other parameters also. So by this we have conclude our program is showing output in serial monitor and serial plotter. And now you can see our mechanism also working here. Thank you.
Myself Pranali Narvade, and I am going to explain future scope, applications and advantages of material sorting machine. Now first of all, here is the model of our project and some future scope about the material sorting machine. Then first content is, we can add a load cell for measurement and control of weight of the product. That means we can also use load cell for the right measurement of the product being sorted. By using this machine, we can also add a counter logic to count the number of product being sorted. Then speed of the system can be increased, accounting to the speed of production. It is also increase the speed of production, that is nothing but the productivity by increasing the speed of system. And we can increase the speed of system by using higher level controllers like Raspberry, etc. By using this machine, the DC motor can be replaced with a stepper motor to have a better accuracy and versatile operating range. The Arduino Uno can be replaced with a PLC, but as we are doing this project for a college level, we have used Arduino Uno, but also Arduino Uno can be replaced with a PLC, that is nothing but the programmable logic controller. It is very useful in a wide varieties of industries like automated sorting machine, enhances efficiency, practicability and safety of the operator. It ensures remarkable processing capacity as well as peerless performance including color detection. By using Arduino based sorting machine, we can be use this machine for industrial purpose like color sorting machine. We can sort different industrial parts according to color. Mostly it can be used in automobile industries, food industries, plastic industries, etc. Actual application of this product can be done in various industries where distribution of product of a different color in one single bar is required. This can be done by our mechanism. There are so many advantages by using material sorting machine. Then sorting machine improves product quality and so add social benefits. It increased efficiency start with the employees working on the floor. Automated sorting machines can consistently do the same repetitive procedure to a high standards, which then lower the occurrence of injuries and accidents. Then it reduced cost when this is combined with an increase throughout the rate. Reduced cost can offer massive benefits for business. The great thing about the automated sorting machine is the fact that the prices is not slow. The process is not slow and the price is also low. Improved accuracy. Human error typically plays a significant role in a number of less than accurate incidents that happens in a facility, especially a parcel sorting machine. By using automated sorter system, the majority of these concerns are removed.